Hello and welcome to Vincent Codes Finance. In this video, I'll show you how you can use stats models to estimate time series regressions and the associated standard errors. We'll first install stats model and prepare a test dataset, and then I'll show you how to use stats model to estimate OLS regression of time series data and the associated OLS standard errors, the white standard errors that are robust to heteroscedasticity, and the HEC standard errors that are robust to both heteroscedasticity and autocorrelation. Stats model is the main module for estimating statistical models and performing statistical tests in Python. So today we'll be looking at the linear regression model. Especially, we'll be looking at the ordinary least square, the OLS model. To install stats model, you do it the usual way with your package manager of choice. You can either use Poetry with Poetry add stats model. You can use it with pip install stats model, or with conda install stats models. In order to test our regression, we'll need some data. So for our examples today, I'll use the data from open source asset pricing. So that's openassetpricing.com. It's the anomalies data from the Chin and Zimmerman paper. We'll look at past anomalies. More specifically, we'll use the momentum data. So to get it, you just go to data and then daily portfolio returns. Takes you to their Google Drive, and we'll use the predictor value weighted data. You can download it. Once you unpack it, you'll see it has multiple CSV files in it. We will only use one. We'll use the momentum 12-month data. To complete our dataset, we'll also merge it with the FAMA French 5-factors dataset that you can get on Ken's French website. So the one we're actually using is the FAMA French 5-factor daily here in CSV format. You don't even have to download it. The way I will load it is directly from the website using Pandas. So the first thing we'll need to do is to import stats model. So in order to import stats model, you could import stats model using the regular API. So statsmodels.api, and then typically you import it as SM. But in this case, I actually want to use the formula API, which gives you a R-like interface in order to run your regression. So you can pass your formulas as strings instead of having to specifying directly the matrices. So this is what I do. So you do import statsmodel.formula.api, and the shortcut for this is SMF. Now we're good, and then we'll need to import pandas as well, because we'll need that to read our data. Once we've got that, then we're ready to load our data. So we'll load the data from Chen and Zimmerman using the 12-month return for the momentum factor. So it is a CSV file. Again, we'll load it up with read CSV. And as we can see, it's been read correctly. We've got the dates as the index, and then the different portfolios there. We actually, if we look at our data frame, we've got multiple portfolio return here. What we'll actually care about is the long short portfolio. Next, I'll load the FAMA French 5-factor data directly. So we can use read CSV and pass in the URL to the file directly. It is important when you read this file, you need to skip the first two rows, which have text and description as to what the data is. And the date column doesn't have a name in the header. So we have to specify directly by number that we want to parse this, column for dates. Now, if we look at the column names from this data set, one is going to cause problem because it has a dash in it, so we won't be able to use it with the formula API. So in order to take care of that, what we'll do is we will reassign our column. What we'll do is we'll replace the dash with a space in our columns. So this should take care of that. And the other thing that we'll do is we will rename our index to date so that the index looks nice. Okay, so now we're good. The last thing we'll do is we'll just join these two data sets. So the way I'm gonna do it is I'm gonna reassign my data frame, the one that contains the Chen and Zimmerman data, sorry, momentum data. I'll just keep the column long short portfolio, and I will join it on this Fama French 5 factor data set, specifying the columns I want to keep, which in this case is all of them. And then I'll make sure that it is a inner join. It won't matter much because there's only there won't be multiple joins there. So now if we look at our data, everything seems okay and is neatly joined. We now have our data and stats model is imported, so we can create our model. So in order to create our model, we'll just define mod our model is equal to SMF, the stats model formula API dot OLS, which takes first the formula. So here what we'll do is we'll regress the long short momentum portfolio on the five factors of Fama French, and we'll specify that we're using DF as our data. So now we have our model. The next step is to estimate our model. In order to estimate the model, all we have to do is use the fit method. So we'll store it in a variable res for result. And what we do is we do model.fit, and that's it. And what we can then do is to look at the summary method. So that produces this regression summary from our model. So here we see we've got our OLS regression result. The intercept, our alpha for this anomaly, even after correcting for the Fama French factor, it is statistically different from zero. We do have a t value of 7.76 here. If we wanted to use the white estimator, then all we have to do is to change the covariance type that is used by the fit method. So instead we would be using res is equal to mod fit, and then we would pass cuff type is equal to HC for heteroscedasticity consistent zero, which is the first one, that's the original white estimator. We also have HC1, HC2, HC3, which are other estimators that are derived from this original estimator. And if we look at the summary that we get here, then we get that our standard errors are slightly different, but not quite visually, but they are, in practice, they will be different. Where we'll actually see the difference is in the t-stats. But as you see here, we don't get the t-stat anymore. We got it by default here. When we change the covariance type, we're getting z statistics. In order to avoid that, we can specify the use t parameter here, make it equal to true. And then when we do that, now we're getting T statistics. And we see that here, for example, for the intercept, it's 7.675, whereas for OLS, it was 7.67. So fairly close, but not exactly the same. Using new OS standard errors, nothing more complicated than the previous two. All we have to do is, again, pass in some parameters to our fit method. But now here we've got a bit more things to do. So the cuff type is equal to HAC for heteroscedasticity and autocorrelation consistent. And then we want to pass some cuff keywords. Cuff keywords, which will be the parameter to this covariance. So this is a dictionary that takes two things. One is the kernel, and in this case it is Bartlett. This is the kernel that is used by the new OS estimator. And the second parameter is max lags, and this max lags
parameter specifies how many lags to use in this model. So for example, we could use 4 or even 5 because we have daily returns. But that's all there is to it. Then we can just go and look at our summary. Again, we've got the Z. So in this case, if we want to have the T value, we'll use T equal to true. And now we can see the difference is a bit more important in this case.
That's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you want to learn more about using stats model for time series regressions, you can check out my blog post linked in the description, where I also provide references to the relevant literature. If you enjoyed this video, please like, and also consider subscribing to the channel if you want to be notified of my future videos.